vote no on this, and the vote would be that we not place it on the ballot in November, obviously you're saying that it could go to court. I mean, what could that do to us if we're voting the way we feel, or we're voting the way constituents would have us vote for our district? I mean, what could they do to us?
Nothing personal. What the writ means, the judge issues a writ and says officials involved are hereby directed to do so and so.
And this was in 1960?
1960.
So we don't think that common sense has prevailed since then in enforcing this. This is similar to the vote that we took a year ago, probably, when they wanted to change the speed limit on 75, and they said you have to vote, but it doesn't matter what your vote is. Which anger would be then, and this anger would be now, that what they're saying is your vote doesn't count, we're going to do it anyway, so just pass it. And I think that takes it out of our hands, and I understand it's a school system issue. I mean, it's a community issue. But let me ask you this, George. Let me play this scenario. When we voted on the millage, did it really matter that we included the city school system's millage in what we voted on?
Yes.
Did it really matter?
Yes. Required to.
Yes. But we could have voted it down.
Yes, we could have voted it down. But again, this let me explain to it in this way. This case involved in 1960, Maxwell Oliver, who was mayor, and he voted against it. He and the council voted it down. Obviously, it was a political issue at the time without raising the taxes. And by coincidence, I'm sure he probably asked some of the same questions you just asked my late law partner, former city attorney, at the time, Henry D. Bryce, who handled the case for the city.
You're channeling people, Robert.
I don't want to tell you about it. I just want to tell you, I'm telling you what the law.
Well, what you're telling us is we don't have a choice. So.
If I may, I'm not sure if that's the case, Robert. And I don't think that anyone in Georgia would ever tell you how to vote.
I agree.
Okay. And I'm looking on the DOT thing. That felt uncomfortable. But I think what Mike, you should look at is the next 3 weeks to 3 months, a court case perhaps, if we happen to miss this ballot date and they are successful in making this, go to a referendum, we have to have a special election to pay for that as well. None of that, should or could matter, but I think you guys are allowed to vote, and I truly feel with every beat in my body how you feel like you should vote, but I think Mr. Talley wanted to show you what my